வாழ்க வையகம் வாழ்க வளமுடன் குரு வாழ்க குருவே துணை பி பிளஸ் பை தி டிவைன் டியர் ஸ்கை இன்டலெக்சுவல்ஸ் ஐ எம் வெரி ஹாப்பி டு வெல்கம் ஆல் ஆஃப் யூ டு தி ஸ்பிரிச்சுவல் டிஸ்கோர்ஸ் இன் இங்கிலீஷ் விச் இஸ் பீங் ஆர்கனைஸ்ட் பை தி வேர்ல்ட் கம்யூனிட்டி சர்வீஸ் சென்டர் ஐடி டீம். The important knowledge about the law of karma should reach the general public in a clear manner. It should be scientifically explained and expressed in such a language that it reaches larger sections of the people, especially the youth, as well as a way to effectively guide their actions and their thoughts. Each individual soul is the aggregate of three karmas and we need to purify them. To elaborate this in detail and explain us how to purify the three karmas, we have our beloved senior professor C. Satyamurthy sir with us tonight. Sir worked in Department of Space for a period of 5 years under Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Then he worked in L&T Limited for 5 years. Later, sir worked as managing director of Fab Machines Private Limited, Bangalore for 30 years. Sir has completed his Sky Master course in the year 1989 and he's been rendering his divine service for the past 32 years. He is the managing trustee of Bangalore Malleshwaram Sky Trust. And also he is presently developing a residential training institute called VETRI, Vedatri Educational Training and Research Institute at Hosur Thali Road, and it is affiliated to the World Community Service Center. I now request our senior professor C. Satyamurthy sir to deliver his talk on the topic how to purify three karmas. Valga Valamudan, be blessed by the divine.
Be blessed by the divine. Is it audible, ma? The voice is okay?
Yes, sir. Very clear, sir.
Okay. The slide, you know, the PPT is moving. Just tell me so that I can. Is it moving?
Yes, sir. It is moving, sir.
Okay. Because sometimes, you know, I may not be in the right mode. So that's why. Okay. Thank you. Let me start. Be blessed by the divine. My pranams to those who are instrumental in bringing this Zoom and those who are working tirelessly to spread the knowledge Vedatriyam through the Zoom and those who are participating today to share my knowledge and experience with Swamiji. I thank you all once again. And let me share this. See the title slide, would you see? How to purify three karmas. What is separating the man from God? The sin separates or the karma separates man from God. Say that is the title slide. If you are able to close the gap, remove the sin, to close the gap, to become one with the divinity, from Jivatma to Paramatma, or from the fractional consciousness to total consciousness, what is required is you'll have to remove the gap. The gap is where the karma separates. So let's see what are all Swamiji has given us. And first of all, Swamiji used to say, whenever he talks, one must focus your goal of life, the purpose of life. So if you focus it, then let other things will fall in line. So then what is our purpose of life? Or the purpose of our visit to this world is nothing but realization of self and self only. Please understand this. Keep this in mind. So then rest No, you are in the right track. That's all. Whenever Swamiji used to talk, he used to write from the atom, he will start and come back, purpose of life, and he'll go on. So the reason for our visit is to realization of self. And how to realize self? To purify or to remove the unwanted imprints or the bad karmas which we have accumulated over a period of time. And in the present life, for that, one needs to develop the knowledge. Development of knowledge is very essential. See, with the development of knowledge only we are able to understand. To understand Swamiji's knowledge and my experience, all those things, you need to develop your knowledge and consciousness. And the consciousness which is abundant in order to realize self, that is what is God's arrangement. That is why we call it as, you know, a providence. It provides everything for us to realize self. So with this understanding, let us proceed. What is karma? The cause and effect. The karma, the cause and effect. This is the basic thing. If you understand, you will always be peaceful and blissful. In this universe, nothing happens without a cause. Today we are all talking about the corona, the novel coronavirus. Apply this law of nature. In this universe, nothing happens without a cause. So if you understand this, then you are peaceful and blissful. Remember this always. So every one of us wants to live long, healthy and a fulfilled life with whatever the resources we have, wherever we are born and however we are. It is very difficult. Now I ask you a question, are you happy? Yes, in the beginning. Then slowly, you know, sir, I have this pain, that pain, or I have some kind of a thought, there is some kind of a disturbance during my, you know, working or travel or whatever it is. We are unable to maintain the peace and happiness 24/7 into 365 days. Why? Because it is very difficult to do this if you don't have any understanding of the unfailed cause and effect system prevailing in the law of nature. So you can just see, not only understanding, it is unfailing cause and effect system. It never fails. So Swamiji say the cause and effect is nothing but God. Action is man, result is divine. So the cause and effect system prevailing in the law of nature, it is unfailing. So that means whatever happens, accept it as a divine judgment. Nothing happens in this universe without a cause. So what is karma? Karma in Sanskrit signifies the action and deed. Any physical or mental action is karma. Thinking is mental karma. So karma is the sum total of our acts in the past, our in generations, both in the present life and in the preceding births. Whatever we have accumulated, 7 generations, they say. See, in terms of spiritual development, karma is all about a person has done in the past generations and from the age of 3, whatever he is doing and whatever he is going to do, will do. And the karma is not about punishment or reward. It makes a person responsible for their own life and how they treat other people. It is very important. Not only your life. Swamiji very clearly says how you treat others at present or in the future to the body or mind. So let us just go back to the basics to understand what is a karma, how it is imprinted and things like that. Let's proceed further. I'm just, if you see something, the obstruction, the biomagnetism gets converted into light and it just goes through your eyes. Eyes are only an equipment or an instrument which converts the biomagnetism into light. So when it goes, if there is any obstruction, it leads to perception. If you see something, it the light rays touches and it comes back to you. You perceive things. So in the process, the diversion of energy causes pain. And over a period of time, about 4 hours, if you start doing your karma by mentally or physically, the exhaustion takes place. The exhaustion is felt as hunger. So Swamiji very clearly say, this is what I think none of these spiritual books I have read, the 10 steps of action and experience is mind. So the hunger, the exhaustion of energy you feel as hunger or a sensation in your feeling of something you want. Exhaustion of energy, want something to put so that you get back your energy. So the sensation is hunger. You need to fulfill, you need something to get back the energy. You put an effort, you swing into action, that gives you a result. The hunger just goes. So then what do we do while eating your food? You enjoy. And that gives you an experience. The sensation of hunger has gone. That gives you a result of enjoyment and experience while eating. Then you will not keep quiet. The mind will not keep quiet. It will just researches and it realizes and comes to a conclusion. So, oh, this is the situation. I must do this. And this is the food. It suits to me based on your body and metabolism. You eat. So that you come to a conclusion. So the 10 steps of action and experience is mind. So this 10 steps of experience, whatever we have experienced in the present life, it becomes one layer of imprint. This imprint from the present life is called prarabdha karma, present life imprint. So prarabdha karma is nothing but from the age of 3, whatever we are able to talk. Otherwise, from the age of 3, only recording. First 3 years, the brain grows. The weight of the brain is only 450 grams while born. Then from 450 grams, it goes up to 1450 grams. 1 kg, the weight it goes. So afterwards only you record many things. So up to 3 years, up from 3 years until the previous second, whatever you have imprinted, that is called prarabdha karma, present life imprint. And we have started our life through our parents, through their gene. We got it. We look like our parents. We inherited their qualities. We don't want disease, but it comes. We have maybe physically, mentally, we have their many qualities. Even if you don't have direct parents, you have your, they look like, no, you are looking like your grandfather and grandmother, something like that. So this is what is we are inherited from the previous imprint, that is called Sanchita Karma through gene. So these two layer of imprints condition one's character or personality. This is how the karma is formed. So just quickly go through it. How, whatever your karma jnanendriyas, whatever you do, how it gets imprinted in our body cells. You look at a cow, it just touches, when it touches your eye lens, it becomes a tiny dot and it goes through the, it falls into your light sensing screen, retina. From the retina, it goes to your optical nerves, it goes to your cerebellum and it just imprinted in the brain cells. And due to gravitational force, it goes to our genetic center. So this is continuously with or without your effort. It just reflects from the birth till death. This is what our personality is. This is how it gets imprinted, with or without our effort. Mind it, without. That is why they say without your effort, idle mind is devil's workshop. With your effort, it becomes a divine workshop. You can make your idle mind as divine or devil based on your effort. So by following the spiritual practices, living in constant awareness, the idle mind becomes a divine workshop. So this is how it gets imprinted. How the qualities are imprinted in mind, Sanchita Karma, the past and the present life put together, Sanchita Karma and the Prarattha Karma, without both the effects, we are going to do our karma the next second onwards in the future, that is called Akamya Karma, the future karma. So we have three karmas in a Sanchita Karma, what we have inherited from our parents, 7 generations. And the Prarattha Karma is our present life imprint, whatever we want to do it with this physical body, the unfulfilled desire of the 7 generation, you may take something and you have started doing it. You have started living with this physical body. Then you do based on the past experience and the present life and the circumstances with whatever you want to do it. That is going to be your Akamya Karma in the future. So these three karmas, if you understand how to purify these karmas, we are going to see now. Now, to understand better, I just do a small experiment. Every one of you, those who are in the Zoom, just close your eyes. Sit comfortably. If you are standing and watching somewhere, hold something on properly and just close your eyes. Just close your eyes. Watch your breath. Cool air getting inside your body and the accumulated toxins goes out of the body. Just watch your breath for a few seconds. Now, I am asking you, just focus your life force, the energy, the biomagnetism, to your happy moments in your life. Happy moments happened in your life, maybe 5 years back, 10 years back, last year, or whatever it is. Go to your happy moments. Oh, you have enjoyed your happy moments. I see. Okay, now switch over to a painful moments or events which happened in your life. Maybe the departure of a near and dear one, or some accidents, or whatever it is. A painful events, loss of business, something like that. Go back. Go to that particular slot or events. Focus it. Good. Now you will move on. Don't open your eyes. Move on to your blissful moments happened in your life. Maybe the day you have taken initiation, or you happen to go to your temple, you enjoyed the presence of the divinity, whatever happened in a blissful events, go back. Go to that blissful events. Happened in your life. Thank you very much. Please open your eyes. Now, if it is in a classroom, I would have told when you are in a happy moment, it is not now in the present. You are sitting in a classroom, or now it is your near house. You had been to your happy moments. Your face was glowing. I saw some brightness in your face. It is not, something happened. It's all stored in your body cells, brain cells. Okay. Now, When the painful event, all the brightness in your face shifted to a long face. I could see all those faces, a blissful face, the happy face has gone to a sorrowful face. Then when I switched on to the blissful moment, and again the brightness, Ojas gets converted into Tejas. I could see some Tejas in your face. So what it says, all those things are stored in our brain cells, five, where all it is getting stored, you all know, but anyhow, we'll go through it again. The subsequent slides, you will see. So this is what our karma, Sanchita karma and Prarabdha karma. So what is sin or what is a bad karma? Let us understand. We do action by thought, word and deed. This action, when the thought, word and deed results in painful, or it results in pain to whom? To self or others, at present or to the in the future, to the body or mind, is a sinful act or a bad karma. See, look at it. See, you, it is self or others. Sitting a very long time today, I'm just giving a small clip. A present, probably you're okay. Future, you'll have a back pain and the body, mind are contaminated. You cursed your the position, the job you are doing, all these things. So when we do an action by thought, word and deed, if that results in pain to self or others at present or in the future, to the body or mind, is a sinful act or a bad karma. If you enjoy your work, please understand, and every 1 hour you go for a small walk, 250 steps, set your, you know, your smartwatch, and you enjoy your friends chatting, doing your work, and you are comfortable, if that is going to result in happiness, not a pain, happiness, it is a good karma. It is not a sinful. So how you look at things is what is a good or bad karma. So let me just tell you what is a bad karma or sin. We do action by thought, word and deed. When it results in pain to self or others at present or in the future, to the body or mind, is a sinful act or a bad karma. Okay. Now, the definition. How do you say, you know, it is from seven generations we have accumulated and things like that. How do you find a sin imprint or a bad karma? Swamiji gives a very beautiful explanation. Disease in the body, disturbance in the mind, or the reflections of individual sin imprints. Let me repeat. Disease in the body, disturbance in the mind, or the reflections of individual sin imprints. It may be emotional, anger, worry, or it may be a nutritional defect, some disease in the body because of the nutritional defect, improper nutrition or malnutrition, or a structural deformities, or a structurally you are weak or strong. So emotional, nutritional and structural. If there is any problem, so that is what the reflection of the sin imprints. Disease in the body, disturbance in the mind, or the reflections of individual sin imprints. So we just simply conclude this way. Take it into a sin is nothing but a bad karma. Okay, now we'll proceed. So what indeed is karma? What are all things we do in our present life? It becomes a bad karma or a good karma. What Swamiji says, at the first level, you know, for the second level, he takes us to a higher level of understanding, rhythm of nature. Number two, development of knowledge. And number three, peace and happiness of self and others. it is deemed a karma, good or bad. So what is the rhythm of nature, and what is the development of knowledge, and what is the peace and happiness of self and others? We do action. Now we will talk about, we do action by thought, word and deed. If the thought, word and deed, it goes against the rhythm of nature or the law of nature, it becomes a bad karma. If you go in accordance with the law of nature, it becomes your good karma. So we'll see one by one the rhythm of nature. The rhythm of nature is what Swamiji says, we are born. Now, to survive, to realize self, you need food. Food is the very fundamental. In philosophy of life, Swamiji says the three needs. First is food. The providence provides. When a mother conceived and carrying, when the child is born, it needs food. It cannot take a pulav. It needs a mother's milk. So the breast milk is provided. So the providence provides. So we need food. Food is the very fundamental need for us to sustain with a good health and to realize self. So the food, work. Then after taking food, we get energy from the society, all that efforts. We get food by the millions of people all over the world. They work. We get food. So that energy, whatever you get, you'll have to convert into energy. You need to do your work to give it back to the society. So we need work. Then at the end of the day, you need to take rest to recoup that energy to again do, to continue your karma the next day. To have the continuity of the human race, you have, the divinity has decided to have the sex. So the continuity takes place. The balance left out karma is sent through your successive generations. And the thought force, we continuously think. So what with these five things, food, work, sleep, sex and thought force, one should not neglect, abuse or misuse or overindulgence. If you do these things, it becomes a bad karma. If you neglect your morning breakfast, you go, you have some physical problem, so you neglected it. Or if you overeat during night time, misuse and abuse, or you fall a victim to the circumstance, you eat something, so that becomes a disease. So overindulgence, whenever you feel like eating it. So these are all causes, food, work, sleep. Again, work, one should not neglect, one should not abuse or misuse or overindulge. One should not neglect the sleep or oversleeping or the lower sleeping, undersleeping. That gives causes, that gives pain and to self and others. How others, if you fall sick, you are not alone. You need, somebody has to take care of your needs. Sickness to be taken over to your hospital, wife and children, they can do a little help. But if it increases, you'll have to take care of hospital. So you need your doctor and that kind of a setup. So with your improper and neglect or overindulgence, you give pain to self and others, sex and thought force. So what Swamiji says, how to make it a good karma? Observe limit and method. Food, work, sleep, sex and thought force. One need to observe limit and method. So follow this. Then you are respecting the law of nature, the path of God realization. The first is very clear to you. You are not going to accumulate any sinful acts or any bad karma. So we'll move on to the development of knowledge. So you'll have a doubt, what is the development of knowledge? By how we are committing bad fools, sinful acts or bad karmas. Swamiji throws a very light in this many, many areas. See, one of which is the development of knowledge is a must to achieve the purpose of life. A few things I would like to say in this area. If you have a child labor in your house, you are not allowing the child to develop the knowledge. any knowledge, a physical knowledge, or if somebody is asking you something, you know it. If you don't share your knowledge, the skills, that means you are not allowing or developing the person to develop the knowledge physically and mentally. So that becomes a bad karma. Where you have learned all these things, you learned from the society. While coming to this world, you have nothing. You have learned everything from the society. So it is your duty to give it back to the society. Paying back the dues to the society is duty. If you don't give back what your knowledge, or if you don't allow somebody to acquire knowledge, is a sinful act. It's a bad karma. To live, to understand, to communicate, you need. So a child labor today, in all respects, is a bad karma. So the development of knowledge by thought, word, and deed, including thought. So let us understand thought, word, and deed. If your action is going to hinder or to acquire the knowledge or the development of knowledge by your thought, word, and deed, it's a sinful act. It's a bad karma. So, and many more. So let us, with this, we'll move on to the third one. Peace and happiness of self and others. By thought, word, and deed, if you spoil the peace of self or the happiness, both self and others. Others mean that include the society. So the peace and happiness of self and others by your thought, word, and deed is a sinful act. So you are not allowing somebody, I just give you a clue. You know, suppose a girl looking, a black, or a servant maid, or maybe some of your own, you know, when we are child, you know, when we are going to school, if someone is black like this, you know, we call them as blackie. And someone is a dwarf figure, we call them as a dwarf. And someone is a fatty, someone is fat, we call them as motu or chotu, whatever it is. So all these things, you know, we think we are only just for fun, we are calling them. But when you deeply analyze and understand the consciousness within these three, blacky, dwarf, fatty, many things, you know, we call them as baldy and whatever it is, tall, short, whatever it is. So what, you know, their mind, or their, it's the mind, the consciousness suffers. Why God has created me like this, a black, dwarf, fat, why it is? Why they are calling me like that? So all their sufferings, mental sufferings, will come back to you. So we simply think that, you know, calling them as blacky, dwarf, it just comes back to you. You spoil their peace and happiness because of their appearance. You cannot call even others a fool. So with all these things, you know, you are putting them, the suffering, the individual peace and happiness is lost. So that is also counted as a sinful act, a bad karma. See, in our own, you know, in our houses, you can see the Krishna and Radhe, you know, really beautiful pictures. Those days it was there. And today it is all something different. Maybe an actress which having a small bit of piece of clothing that is displayed in the house. You think it is not, it is how it is a sinful act or a bad karma by putting such kind of things, you know, I can show you something like that in a small statue, a bronze statue, or even a sculptor, maybe a marble or a stone statue without clothing. So that induces a sexual feeling. Those who are coming into your, you know, sitting and chatting in your house, in your lobby, or in your hall, such kind of things are displayed. Swamiji says you are inducing their sexual instinct in others. So you spoil the peace and happiness of yourself, and you are spoiling the peace and happiness of others. So these are all things, very subtle things. It causes or a bad karma in you. So what is sin and virtue? What is the difference between sin and virtue? Why people say, talk about only sin, why not virtue? Let us understand. Action which keeps tied down to this world, the worldly things, or bad karmas, or a sinful act. Anything which tied down your soul to get liberated from the bondage of life and death cycle in this world, all are bad karmas. So that is sin. And what is the virtue? The action that leads towards realization of self or virtues. So now let us understand, Swamiji very clearly says, the action that leads towards realization of self or virtues. So we have entered in this world because of our bad karmas or bad impurities, sin imprints. So what is our role? To purify, to remove. If you do only virtuous things, then only your karmas will never get accumulated. So purpose of life is to purify our bad karmas. So if doing our virtue becomes our duty, we are not going to multiply our karma, or we are not adding our karma. So people, they don't talk about virtue because virtue becomes one's own duty, one's own good karma. So virtue becomes our duty. It is not counted simply. Only the bad karmas, the sin imprints will get manifested. The good ones, it becomes our duty. If you have this kind of an idea, virtue once duty, then we will be doing only good karmas. So to wipe out our bad karmas, this is a very simple technique for God realization. Sorry. Then how do you assess your karma? The motive and results decides an action to be bad karma or virtue. The motive and result. It's again thought, word and deed. Please have that in mind. Even by thinking. See, that is why, the man who motivates, who gives an idea, he is also taken into task. You are the person who gave the idea. So the motive and the result decides an action to be bad karma or virtue. So you can assess your karma like that. So how to identify sin or virtue? A bad karma. The time, the place, the object of contact, motive and result. That's a granite. A soldier working in the battlefield of Indochina border or Indo-Pakistan border to prevent the intruders, the foreigners. He could see, and then he throws a bomb and hand grenade. In the process, he also loses his leg. He stopped about 10 people. They all killed. So he has been given a greatest award, a Paramveer Chakra. Okay. By that, he gets retirement, comes back to his village. There is a dispute between the two communities in the village, a jatra or a village function, a deity's function. So what happens in that way? This fellow was in one side, he throws a grenade on the other side and few people are hurt. To threaten them, he just throws it. So will he get an award? He will put behind bars. See, there, the time, it is the war time, place is the battlefield. The object of contact is to prevent them getting inside our area, beyond our line of control. Motive is he has to protect the country, patriotism. So the result is he has prevented them. So you can identify your karma. The throwing a hand grenade, the action remains same, but the result is time, place, object of contact, motive, and result decides. Like an operation theater, a doctor uses in an operation theater a knife, cuts open the stomach, he removes all the whatever it is, the unwanted things, a tumor. But the same doctor uses his knife to slit the throat of somebody. Again, the time, place, subject of contact, and motive and result. Here the patient is, operation is successful, but there with that knife he slit somebody's throat and it put behind bars. The same way, a judge, by doing that action, the doctor is put behind bars, then for killing somebody using the knife, after the proper investigation, then the judgment being given by the judge. He says he has to be put behind bars for 13 years or hanged him till death. So doctor killed him and he has put the action, for that he is punished for the death sentence. So the judge is also giving a death sentence. So is he not committing a sinful act? How to identify all these three actions? Is again the time, place, object of contact, motive and result. Here it is, the judge, he reads out as per the IPC, so and so have been put, he just reading out, accepted by the society, formed, framed by the society. So it is in the courtyard, place, and object of contact after the proper investigation. Motive, he should not do such kind of act again. It's just a warning to the rest of the community. So the result is people will fear to do such kind of a bad karma. So this is how one can identify the karma, good or bad. So where all this getting imprinted? Body cells, brain cells, the seed cells, biomagnetism and the universal magnetism. Body cells, an expansion and contraction, you'll be knowing about it, but still, for the newcomers, I'm just giving you an idea. Reciting a poem, it is all in body cells. The latest research says that even the tissue in the ligaments and tendons, all the experiences imprinted, they found out with the experiments with a very subtler level, it has it. An individual cell take this and a cell from the body and they keep a poison and a sweet on the other side, nectar. The cell moves towards the nectar, not towards the poison. All that things are in each and every cell. In body cell, it is imprinted. Brain cell, we did an experiment in the beginning, closing our eyes. So all that brain cells, it is imprinted. We go to our past, blissful, happening, painful, and a happy moment, we all experienced it. Seed cell, in the DNA, we have it. That's what is our emotions. We all experience it. And the biomagnetism, that is what, that becomes our character. But through a Krillian photography, you can see when you are in an emotional mood. You can see the red, blue, and green, and yellow. And the universal magnetism, this is what Swamiji very clearly says, it is the Akashic imprint. So these five places, it is getting imprinted. Can it be dissipated? Can this karma be dissipated? Yes, it is possible. Very boldly says, many religious people, they will say, They will just dodge and go out. But Swamiji and very few saints, they said it. It is possible. There is a lock. To open the lock, there must be a key. So God's design is like that. Can sin be dissipated? Yes, it is possible. Assess and understand the degree of imprint. Counterbalance with good imprints. The good imprints brings peace and ecstasy, happiness and bliss. So if you understand it is possible, let's proceed how it is. Imprints bring sufferings to physical and mental. But now we have come to the title of the today's talk. What are the three karmas? Sanchita karma, prarabdha karma, and akamya karma. How to purify? By expiation, by doing parihara or prayachitta, you can purify the future karmas. We'll see one by one. And the superimposition is your present life imprint. Prarabdha karma. By doing superimposition, you can purify your present life imprints. And by doing a dissolution or neutralization, you can purify your Sanchita karma. Let's see what are the methods, what Swamiji has given us very beautifully. Expiation. You're just going out of your room or a hall in your office somewhere, you happen to your lip touches the other person. So what do you say immediately? I'm sorry. Immediately the other person says thank you. So that means expiation. You ask for an apology. I'm sorry. He told you thank you. So a correction has taken place. The future karma is not there. If you think that fellow stretched his legs, why should I ask for an apology? If you just go out, the fellow who has affected, no, he will say, look at that fellow, without even telling sorry, he's going late. While coming, I will stretch my legs. I will make him trip and fall down. So, your future karma, you're invited. So, asking for an apology and telling thanks, your future karma is no more in a classroom. Or with a vegetable render, or you happen to just hit him or something like that, you ask for an apology, compensate by whatever the money you have. If the fellow lost by your thing, ask for an apology, pay him money. And if you have overeaten something, maybe because of your forcefulness of your friend or something like that, in a meeting, your boss says, come on, man, take it. Okay, overeat it. What do you do? After coming home, you don't eat whatever it is. You take a soda, you take something like a ginger and lemon juice. You are balancing it. So the expiation, doing parihara or prayachitta, then your future karma is no more there. How to do that? Swamiji has given us a perfect tool, Ajna meditation. That is why when a new aspirant comes, he directly raises from Mooladhara to Ajna chakra, bypassing all that other the chakras or the centers. Why? Because it gives you a constant awareness. By meditating on the Ajna chakra, the pituitary gland, it gives a constant awareness. Even medical science today proves 12 hours, if you go from beta to alpha level, a 4 to 7 cycles, then say 5 frequency, say cycles per second, then that remains for next 12 hours. So that means by starting your life with an Ajna meditation in the early morning, so start the day with meditation. So you came to a calm state of mind so that you will retain it for next 12 hours. So that means you will live in constant awareness. By living in constant awareness, you will not commit any mistake. You don't draw any money. You don't draw any loan. So you don't need to pay an EMI. So that way, you don't commit any sinful acts. So you don't need to pay it. So your future karma is pure. So one karma is pure by meditating on the Agni Chakra. You live in constant awareness. Your future karma is purified, avoiding the bad karmas in the future. So the expiation by doing, asking for an apology or correction will help you to purify your akamya karma. Future karma is akamya karma. So now, the present life imprint, prarabdha karma, is whatever, you know, we have experienced it. Whatever, you know, we had been to our past, present in the 3 years until now, whatever we have imprinted in our brain cells, when you go to that particular slot, it just comes out. All that imprint, all that just, you know, there in the brain cells, it magnifies, comes to your monitor. To resolve not to repeat such sinful acts in the future. To do only good to self and others. You need to superimpose. All those things are imprinted in our brain cells. So, to cut, paste and edit on the bad imprints, what do we do? Like, you know, cut, paste and edit, copy, paste, cut, paste. You know the keyboard, you think of it. So, just see, the prarabdha karma is whatever happened from 3 years until now, one can superimpose the positive thoughts and right actions. Whatever is superimposed will never come again. You just play, say, a record, a tape recorder, the old song, imprint upon the present song, you superimpose it. Then you play again, you will hear only the newly imprinted song. So you can free from prarabdha karma, the present life imprint, by doing turiya meditation, by meditating on the pineal gland, which is floating in hypothalamus. It is a receiver and a transmitter. So you can receive with positive thoughts from the cosmos, doing good actions. You can superimpose, cut, paste and edit on the negative thoughts, on the bad karmas. You purify your present life imprints, the prarabdha karma. So there are a lot of examples, but anyhow, the time is not there. I am just moving on. So prarabdha karma by doing, meditating on the pineal gland, the master gland to the mind, all that imprints, you can purify it with this birth only. Only your will is required. Sit down. Swamiji has given a lot of techniques. Analysis of thought, moralization of desire, neutralization of anger, eradication of worries. Take a piece of paper, like cut, pasting and edit, whatever is there is imprinted. Just take a piece of paper, write down, is it good for self, family and society? If it is going to give pain to self, others, family and society, nip the thought, a desirous thought or an angry thought or a worried thought, nip at the thought at the root level itself. By introspection and meditating on the pineal gland, you can superimpose your present life imprint, prarabdha karma. So the second karma can also be cleansed by doing cut, paste and edit, positive thoughts and right actions. Now we are moving on to the third and final karma. Neutralization by a technique called neutralization or dissolution. See, man commits misdeeds and the suffering continues generations after generations. We don't want a disease. but without asking it comes. When you go to a doctor, you say your father had it, no. Your grandfather had it, no. Your great grandfather may have it, so it got it. Great grandfather's property has come to you. You use their name and fame. My grandfather was a great lawyer, was a great teacher. He was an MP or MLA. We use our name, fame. We use their quality. We get our emotions. We get our diseases. The same way we get our karmas also. It's a package deal designed by the law of nature. So man commits misdeeds and suffering continues. It becomes generations after generation. That is called Sanchita Karma. Sanchu is back. So through the uterus, we started our life. All that through gene, it has come to us. So that is called a Sanchita Karma. It is there. All the karmas are there in the back. If you put your hand also, you cannot find out. Maybe you can get something, but you are unable to read out. At what understanding, what they did it, present, is it suits or not, we don't know. So a Sanchita Karma, you cannot identify exactly what it is. So for that, Swamiji says, suppose an acid falls in your hand. What do? Suddenly, you just put your hand in a water. Dip it in water. You just dilute the acid. You don't know what kind of an acid. Whatever it is, just dilute it. So that is how the Turiyatita Dhyana, Swamiji has made it. In Turiyatita Dhyana, the Sanchita Karma gets purified. In Sanchita Karma, you don't know what it is, how it is, who has made it, at what understanding, all those things. So when you do your Turiyatit meditation, you merge yourself with the divinity, 1-3 frequency. You expand your consciousness. You are one with the divinity. With that level, a 1-3 frequency, that is why they call that frequency as delta. In that delta wave, see the delta, you can just see the sea gets inside the land. That area is called delta. So all that accumulated toxins or all those things is called as a river. See, like our individual name, the river flows from higher level to lower level, and it is not just like that going to fall inside the sea. When you go to the Turiyatit level, you are 1-3 frequency. You are in the magnetic field of God. So God will embrace you. Like, a magnet and a needle, a nail, and both of them are, bring the needle to a magnet, it just attracts and it catches. It will never fall down. After a few days, you take out the needle or a nail, you see the magnetized, the needle or the nail is magnetized. From where it got the magnetism, it got it from the magnet. So that way, when you do regularly your Turiyatit meditation, the God will hug you, embrace you. Oh my child, oh millions of years you are gone. I gave you a long rope. I gave you free will. You used the free will and now you realized you are in the right place with the right guru and the right technique. You are near, you are one with me. It just embraces you. So that divine qualities like love and compassion, it just comes to you. And all the bad things, when the river just mixes with the ocean water in the delta region, it takes away all that karmas, bad impurities of the river. It gets inside the sea. So it becomes an ocean. You cannot say that this is Kaveri River, Ganga River and things like that. It just once mixes with the ocean, it becomes ocean. So once you do Turiyatit meditation, you are one with the divine, all your Sanchita Karma has taken care of by the divinity, cleansed, purified, taken away. So in Turiyatit meditation, in that 1-3 frequency, your past karmas, Sanchita Karma is purified. You get the divine qualities of love and compassion. So by to summarize, by doing Ajna meditation You can get away with your future karma, akamya karma, by doing turiya meditation on the pineal gland, cut, paste and edit with your present life karmas. By positive thoughts and right actions, you purify your present prarabdha karma. And by doing turiyatit meditation, you purify your sanchita karma. So akamya karma, prarabdha karma, and sanchita karma, all are purified. The technique is given. Swamiji, if you do it with faith and understanding, you are there. Many times we get this kind of a doubt. A sinner goes into a Benz car. See, this is where we see only a fellow goes in a Benz car. But what is happening inside? Even though he has put the full blown of AC, will never give you the cold effect, the blissful feeling. But inside he is boiling. When I get down the car, somebody will shoot me down. A sinner at place is not at peace. A sinner is not at good health. He will never have a sound sleep. He has to take a little amount of alcohol for a sleep, or he has to take a sleeping pills. So, is sinner free to consume food to his choice? He cannot. Even though he has a bank balance in 10 digits, he cannot take. He has got a lot of family problems. He cannot free from disease. A sinful imprints are passed on to the successive generations as disease and disturbance. But one can purify it. If anybody is in this state of mind, God has given you all the solutions. One can practice the spirituality, Vedatriyam. You can purify your all impurities. You are not born to suffer. A honest man toiling for livelihood today, you see why that man is suffering, why, what karma he did. On the other hand, he is able to sleep well. Whatever the karma is, he just able to sleep well. Even though he's not a money, but he is comfortably sleeping on the road. He don't need a sleeping pills or an alcohol. He's got a good health. Enjoy the peace and happiness at home. Honest man is suffering, but we see only the outside, but inner, he is in blissful state. His successive generations enjoy good health, peace and happiness. So for that, the two principles for not accumulating more sin imprints, what do we do? Do not expect anything from anyone. Expectation causes problem. So do not expect anything from anyone in your life. So for that, what do? Sit and assess yourself. Where are you? What are you? What's your physical strength, financial strength? What is your social support? Look at all these things. In which way I can help? In others, if you look at these things, you will not expect anything from others. So by sitting and analyzing yourself, what are you? Where are you? How are you? What are all your strength? Sit down and assess, you will get the ideas. Assess your age, strength, health, working skills, education, environmental opportunity, power, financial status, the experience of your life. Above all, your stock. Above all is your stock. By using this, in which way I am going to be helpful to self, family and society and the nation, you can live and lead a blissful life. Because time is there. Okay. So, conclusion, concentrate on spiritual development, enlightenment of consciousness. So let us all jointly work and contribute our thought, word and actions and service to this noble aim of world peace. To achieve the purpose of life, intensify your meditation. Then Start your day with meditation. End your day with meditation. Swamiji has given us a lot of meditation techniques. All those meditation techniques, use it. Whenever you get time, there are 24 hours in a day. So reprogram, rewrite, introspect your thought, word and deed in such a way not to harm others. By this way, one can spread the light of virtue. Result, all the needs of one's living will be provided generations after generations. With this understanding, let me conclude my experience and teachings of Swamiji. Thank you very much for your patient hearing. Be blessed by the divine. God bless you all. By the grace of divine, you will all enjoy good health, long life, enough wealth, prosperity, wisdom and peace. Be blessed by the divine.
Be blessed by the divine. Thank you so much, sir, for your stimulating speech with insightful presentation. Our Guru Yogiraj Sri Vedatri Maharishi felt that everyone should be taught about the philosophy of the karma at the young age itself. He also felt that the changes towards the better living should happen intuitively. To make it happen in the young minds, the education system should include the philosophy of karma as a part of the curriculum. Our senior professor, Sri Satyamurthy sir, has very well explained about the purification of the three karmas. Thank you so much, sir, for giving your valuable time in explaining this wonderful topic. Thank you, sir. Now the forum is open for discussion questions. Please click the raise hand button in your Zoom app to ask your questions to our professor. While you get ready with your questions, we have some important announcements to make. Practice Kayakalpa regularly and improve your immunity system. If not yet learned Kayakalpa Yoga, please visit our kayakalpayoga.edu.in. Download the Android app. Recommend it to your friends and relatives. Our monthly journal Anboli is also available in the Android app. Download the Android app from the Android Play Store. Get access to the premium content of Swamiji's speeches. As you may be aware, we are daily uploading rare videos of Swamiji in the Anboli app. Connect with us on Facebook and YouTube channel at Sky Yoga TV to listen to all the past speeches of our professors on various aspects of our Sky Yoga. Karma Yoga principles of Vedatriyam suggest donating 1% of your income to the good causes of the society. Be generous in donating to the World Community Service Center. There are multiple channels to do that. Either you can donate through the Anboli app or you can also donate through our official website, that is vedatri.edu.in. Just to mention, you would get Section 80G exemptions as well as for these donations. Thank you. Now the question and answer session. Vijay, you can raise your question, sir. Please unmute by your end.
Hello, sir. Good evening. Today is the first day I am attending your session just through the main website. Okay. What is the timing you daily take these Zooms calls and sessions? Can I know further details so that I can join and attend regularly?
You have underwent all these sky meditation techniques?
Yeah, I'm a BSc student, second year BSc student. This year I didn't write the exams. I undergone the all meditations and introspection practices as well. I'm in Tamil Nadu only, but I like to listen in English as well. I also want to be a future trainer like you.
Very nice. So, what you can do is at 7:55 every day, an English discourse will be there. And some days it is going to be in other languages, in Hindi, Malayalam, and Tamil and things like, sorry, in Kannada and things like that. So you can 7:55 every day.
Evening. You'll have,
Okay.
Yeah, every day. But I don't know it's going to be up this month end. But you can go to the website and you can find out, or you talk to the, I will give you the mobile number. You can talk to them and find out. And if you want to become a teacher in English, we have an English club. You can join there.
Yeah, it will be nice. Actually, right. I follow Tamil and like the Tamil as well. But yeah. English will also, I like to learn in English. Like,
good thing.
Want to train English means I have to listen and practice in English as well.
Sure.
Right?
Okay. So you just send your number. We will add your name in the Sky Club, English Sky Club. You can probably participate and learn and you become a good teacher. You are welcome.
Yeah, thank you, sir. I will message in chat
yeah.
box.
Yeah, you can. You see my number, then I will refer you to the club. Then they will add your number. You can participate.
The number is in the screen. Should I have to message the number which in the screen,
yeah,
right?
True. Yeah, yeah. In the screen, you message it. I will put you to the right person.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Be blessed.
Thank you, sir. Madam Padma, you can raise your question.
Vaazhga Valamudan Ayya. So I'm actually Padma from Bangalore.
Yeah.
Sir, one thing is little unsettling for me, so I wanted to ask you this.
Yeah.
So you mentioned that from generations together, through Sanchita Karma, the imprints will be transferred or carry forward.
Yeah.
So my question is, so I have kids. So I'm not able to take this concept, or, you know, why should my children suffer because of something that I did, or, you know, my previous generations did? Isn't it unfair for the for that person? So if you call it as a soul, isn't it unfair for the next soul to carry forward these Sanchita Karma?
Okay. What is your bank balance? What is your... Do you have any assets? Your fathers or grandfather? You might have built a house, maybe, or may not be. So all yes. these things...
Mm-hmm.
It goes to whom?
Children.
Children only.
Yes.
Okay. If you are a good orator or maybe a good doctor, they use your name and fame or not?
Yes, sir. See. That is also true. Yes.
So, see, God has designed in such a way, and the providence it provides, you know, in such a way that without any suffering, one has to undergo this. It's a divine judgment. See, you inherited your parents' strength, wealth, health, disease, everything. So the karma is also added on to it. Buy 2 pants, 1 t-shirt free. It's a package deal.
Okay.
So without this, you know, it is not completed. See, otherwise, you know, somebody, what he will do, I'll just give you a small example. See, a fellow wanted his brother's land. A fight between two brothers. So if I kill or do something, so I get his piece of land, I can live happily and peacefully. So after that demise, he killed his brother and he enjoyed it. Both the land of, say, 20 acres, 10 put together, 20 acres. Just the fellow, the elder fellow got it. So after his demise, his children are going to enjoy. Is it fair or unfair?
It's unfair, sir.
That is how it is. That is what, if you understand, if the children comes to the spiritual knowledge, please understand. See, that is why Swamiji has given. If you understand the spiritual knowledge and the spiritual concept, okay, then you will not take that kind of property or all those things comes. Oh no, it is accumulated from those things, so I should not take it. With my Swamiji's 14 principles of life, you know, I will earn and live with my earnings only. I will not kill anything for my food. Something like that. 14 in this philosophy, Swamiji explained very clearly why it is all coming, because our hereditary imprints, it's a package deal. God has designed it. I have to accept it. It's a divine judgment. But what we can do, when the children are growing, you teach them the philosophy, take them to the spiritual classes, understand how it works. Then they will live and lead a peaceful and blissful life. None of these karmas will pass down to them. If they practice it, they know the techniques to purify it.
Mm-hmm.
So please teach them. See, we all came here to these Vedatri and philosophy, learnt it. Now we are leading and living a blissful life. It's yes, a God's design. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you are nobody to question it. Sorry.
Okay.
Thank you, Ma.
Thank you very much for the lovely Thank exam.
You. Okay. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Next, N. Rajeshwari, madam, you can ask your question.
ಸರ್ ವಾಳ್ಗ ವಳಮುಡನ್
ವಾಳ್ಗ ವಳಮುಡನ್
ಸರ್ ನನಗೆ ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಇರೋದು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಸ್ಪೀಚಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ಸರ್ ನನಗೆ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ನಿಜವಾಲು ಈವನ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ತಮಿಳಿಗಿಂತನ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ತುಂಬಾ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆ ಬಟ್ ಮೈ ಮದರ್ ಟಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ತೆಲುಗು ನನಗೊಂದು ಐ ನೋ ತಮಿಳ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಒಂದು 75% ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಬಟ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬಾ ಸುಲಭವಾಗಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರಿ ನೀವು ಸೊ ಈವನ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಲರ್ನ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್ ಟ್ರೈನಿ Even though, but I don't, I know only zero.
Okay. Not zero, ma.
Not
zero. Why
do you say zero? No, sir. Comparing to this knowledge, the same subject, actually, I want to talk in Atma Sangha.
Very nice. Very nice. Okay. I'll give you.
Atma Sangha.
Okay, ma. No. Bekadra nanige nan mobile number ide nodi. ನನ್ನ ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಗೆ 2221 ಗೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ
ಸರ್ ನನಗೆ ಅದು ಫೇಸ್ಬುಕ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬರಲ್ಲ ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ನಾನು ನಂಬರ್ ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ ನೀವ್ ಏನಾದ್ರು ಸ್ಪೀಚಸ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ನನ್ಗೆ ಈಗ ನನ್ನ ನಂಬರ್ ಕಳ್ಸಿದ್ರೆ ಸಾಕು ನಂಗೆ ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಹುಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಬರಲ್ಲ ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ
ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಡು ದಟ್
ಇಫ್ ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ನನ್ನ ನಂಬರ್ ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ
ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ
ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಸರ್ ಐ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮೈಸೆಲ್ಫ್
ಗುಡ್ ಗುಡ್ ಓಕೆ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಮಾ ಇಟ್ ಶೋಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸ್ಪಿರಿಚುವಲ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರೆಸ್
ಶಾಲ್ ಐ ಗಿವ್ ಮೈ ನಂಬರ್ ಸರ್ ಯಾ ಐ ಆಮ್ ದಿ ಲೈನ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಸೇಮ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಶಿಷ್ಯರ ಹತ್ರನೇ ನಾನು ಇರೋದು ಬಟ್ ಏನಂದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಒಂದು ಎಷ್ಟು ಹೇಳ್ತೀರಾ ನೀವು ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ಈವನ್ ಒನ್ ಒನ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅನ್ನೆಸೆಸರಿ ಹೇಳಲ್ಲ ನೀವು ಎಷ್ಟು ಬೇಕೋ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ವೇದಾದ್ರಿ ಮಹರ್ಷಿ ಈಗಲೂ ನೀವು ಅದೇ ಇಡ್ಲಿ ತಗೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರಿ ಅದೇ ಆಹಾರ ತಗೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ಗೆ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಅದರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್ ಎಷ್ಟು ದೊಡ್ಡವರು ನೀವು ನನಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿದೆ ನಾನು ಅವರು ಆ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಚನ್ನಪಟ್ಟಣ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಮದುವೆನಲ್ಲಿ ನೋಡಿದ್ದೀನಿ ನಾನು ನಿಮ್ಮಿಬ್ಬರನ್ನು ಮಾತಾಡ್ಸಿದ್ನೇ ನೀವು ನನಗೆ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಗೊತ್ತು ನಿಮಗ್ ನಾನು ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಬಟ್ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಮಾತಾಡಕ್ಕೆ ನನಗೆ ಅವಕಾಶ ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ಟುಡೇ ನಾನ್ ರಾಜೇಶ್ವರಿ ಸರ್
ಓಕೆ ರಾಜೇಶ್ವರಿ
ನನ್ನ ನಂಬರ್ 8 7 6 2 6 2 7 3 7 3 1 7 1 7 1 6 1 6
so let me repeat
1 6
8 7
ತುಂಬಾ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ನಿಮ್ಮಿಬ್ರು ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಮೀನಾ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ನಿಮ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ತುಂಬಾ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ನಮ್ಗೇನಂದ್ರೆ ಪರ್ಸನಲ್ ಆಗಿ ವೆಟ್ರಿಗ್ ಬರಕ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ವಾ ಅದ್ರಿಂದ ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಸ್ಪೀಚಸ್ ಆದ್ರೂ ಹೀಗೆ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬಾ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿದೆ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಕಂಪೇರಿಟಿವ್ಲಿ ತಮಿಳ್ ನಾನು ಎರಡೂ ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರಿ ನಿಮ್ದು ಬಂದಾಗೆಲ್ಲಾನು
ಮೊನ್ನೆ ಕನ್ನಡ ಇತ್ತಲ್ಲ ಕೇಳಿದೀರಾ ಆತ್ಮಸಂಗಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಇಲ್ಲ
ಆತ್ಮಸಂಗಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಕೇಳಕ್
ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಧ್ಯಾನ
ನಾನು ಧ್ಯಾನ ಸಂಗಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಕೇಳಿ ನಾನು ಗೌರಿ ಮೇಡಮ್ ಜೂಮ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಮೆಡಿಟೇಷನ್ ಒಪ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೆ ಅವತ್ತಿನ ದಿನ ಸೊ ಅದೊಂದು ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತು ಆ ಕ್ಲಾಶ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು ಬಟ್ ಇದು ಮಾತ್ರ ನಾನು ಮಿಸ್ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ ಈ 752 ಇದು ಮಾತ್ರ ಖಂಡಿತ ಮಿಸ್ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ ನಾನು ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ನನಗೆ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್ ಗಾಡ್ ಬ್ಲೆಸ್ ಯು
ಓಕೆ ಸರ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ನನಗೆ ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಲ್ಲ ಆದ್ರಿಂದ ನೀವು ಆಗಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಒಂದು ನಾನೊಂದು ನಿಮಗೊಂದು ಶಿಷ್ಯರಂತ ಅನ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮೊಬೈಲ್ ಕಳಿಸಿ ಸಾಕು ನಾನು ಕೇಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಪಿಕಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಿಡ್ತೀನಿ
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು
Be blessed by the divine. Thank you so much, sir. We have last question. Geeta Suresh, you can ask your question.
Good evening, sir. Blessed by the divine. Sir, I am also doing advanced diploma course.
Madam, from where you are calling? Your name
I am
and...
calling from Bangalore, sir. Bangalore, Vidyaranyapura. Oh, and I am hearing from Kannada training in a group and I am writing an English exam. So all your speeches are helping me a lot. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And, now you told about that imprints, no, sir? It will get imprinted in the brain cells and body cells and genetic center and biomagnetism and universal magnetism, you told us, sir.
Yes.
So body, it is okay, but in universal magnetism and biomagnetism, how it will get imprinted? I have a doubt, sir.
Okay. No, people, you have been taught, you know, if you do not say some bad words or do not utter something stupid way, see, that way there are some angels are there, it will say tatastu, age agli. So that way our elders are taught us. So like, you know, all these, see, when to Akashic imprint, I'll give you another example. See, when you go to somebody's house, you are comfortable. You feel like staying more time, spend more time with them. You are comfortable. And when you go to somebody's house, another, you are unable to sit for even 10 minutes. You are disturbed. So why this happening? See, like, you know, cinema theater and a temple, all these things are Akashic imprint. See, people coming to a temple, they ask for good things. People going to a cinema theater, all that negativities are there. You go to cinema theater with a lot of zeal and enthusiasm. You come out with your energy sapped by the bad magnetism or the Akashic imprint. It sucks away your life energy. You, while getting out of the cinema theater, you know which direction to go to your house. When you go to your temple in an exhausted way, in the time which where you have exhausted your energy, get into your temple, you are charged with the divine energy. See, these are all the Akashic imprints. When you go to somebody's house, why you are disturbed? Because in that house, they fight. All that negativities will trouble you. That is why you are unable to stay there even for minutes, 10 minutes. If somebody's house, they have a pray for good things, they are all thinking good, doing good. In that house, you are comfortable. So that is how the Akashic imprint works. Be blessed by the divine.
Thank you, sir, for patiently answering our questions and sharing your insights and divine thoughts with us. Dear participants, it is a time for us to express our thanks and gratitude to our professor. Kindly all come to Durya State. Senior Professor C. Satyamurthy, sir, be blessed by the divine. His good health, be blessed by the divine. His loving family, be blessed by the divine. His divine service, be blessed by the divine. Thank you, sir, for joining with us. Please keep enlightening us with such more interesting and valuable topics. Thank you, sir. We would like to extend our blessings to the Sky Meditators for their kind donations made. Your generous donations will help us a lot to serve the society. By the grace of the divine bliss, may you all enjoy good health, long life, enough wealth, peace, prosperity, and wisdom. Be blessed by the divine. We are happy to bring the following online programs live from Alia Temple of Consciousness tomorrow. Morning 6 a.m. we have exercises in Tamil. 7 a.m. we will have 9 center meditation in Tamil. 7:30 a.m. we have 9 center meditation in English. By 11 a.m. we have speech in Tamil on the topic Gidai and Vedatriyam by Professor Tirnau Karusu from Udumalai. Evening 6 a.m. we have Duryadida meditation in Tamil. 7:30 p.m. we have Panchendra meditation in English. 7:55 night we have speech in English by Sky Professor. Please share this program, invite with your friends and relatives. Let everyone take part in the spiritual journey and get benefited. We thank our beloved President Arulidhi Padmashri SKM Mailanandan sir for his support and leadership and guidance. Thank you all Sky members for participating in today's Aliyar Zoom session. See you all tomorrow with another interesting session. Till then, be safe, practice our Kundalini Yoga. This is Jamuna Mani from Aliyar World Community Service Center IT team. Be blessed by the divine. Good night.